I learned oh so much back when I was that big. And in 1972, I had the chance to go and make a record. And I always said, if ever I did become a singer, which is what I wanted to do, I wanted to follow in his footsteps. If I ever did get the chance to do that, this would be the first song that I recorded. And it happened in 1972. The record came out in 1973. But it happened in 1972 in a cellar in Wakefield, and the engineer on the job was Richard Whiteley. And he was the man doing twisting all the knobs and everything. He went on to greater things, and I'm working here in Ripon. But there you go, I'd rather be here than where he is now, let me tell you. Anyway, I'll finish with all. Thanks for the request, and thanks for listening. You've been absolutely marvellous. If I could leave you with one little thought, it's this: never put off until tomorrow what you can do today. Because if you enjoy it, you can do it again tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Yeah. I'm really pleased you took me, and I feel really honoured that I'm able to stand here next to you and sing now, because, you know, it's oh, my mum's welling up, look. Don't cry, Mum. We're not going to sing out horrible, are we? But yeah, we've asked Jonny if he'll do this one, because it when I think of John Aston, I don't know, this song, I just think I associate this song with you, because it's one that we've heard you do for a number of years, and it's just a great song. I think
it's a earnest talk. Just to say, we would like to finish off this one. And thank you so much, everybody, for coming. You've been a wonderful audience and wonderful guests. Hope you enjoyed yourself. We look forward to seeing most of you next year. Well, we'll see you before then, of course. Thank you so much. Do have a safe journey on those that are travelling, especially the ones all the way back up to Scotland. Well, thank you for coming. And we'll leave you with this one. Walking the floor over you.
It is, just before we do that, yeah. I've just sat and listened to a fabulous set. And I've thoroughly enjoyed that, Jonny and Lynnette.
Thank you very much.
And my sort of affection for Lynnette now has grown a little, because she just said that her favourite lady singer is Loretta Lynn. She happens to be mine as well. So my very first song of Loretta Lynn, and I think that you should do this. I'm going to do about a verse and a half of it. Is that okay?
Yeah, go ahead.
And I think that this should be Lynnette's next song. And it is available. I just can't get it through my head. You love another now instead. You need. Can't believe. Can't come true. I'm walking. But they've actually asked for this one, which is actually an old sort of Western swing type thing that was done by Ernest Tubb originally, I do believe. And
don't expect me to play any fancy breaks on it. I'll just have to pick along with one. So I don't know. I'm not rehearsed there.
You know when you give advice to people, right? I've got some for you. Be brave.
Be brave. Yeah.
You know that What Colour Is the Wind? Did you know the story behind that? Yeah. Do you know the story behind that?
Yeah.
Pete Naden, who actually gave Charlie the idea for that, had overheard a conversation, and apparently a little blind girl had asked What Colour Is the Wind, and he didn't know what to do with it. He told it to Charlie, and within a day he'd wrote a song about it. Absolutely. But I met Pete Naden just about 18 months ago. Did you know that he's Alzheimer's now? He's very, very bad with it, so, which is a shame. Anyway, get on with it. Back to this.
Back on what the team's actually.
I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, that is true. I'm hoping and I'm praying that my heart breaks mine in two. Walking the floor over you. Back in just a day.
decision there, John. Better hang Williams. Let's kick it up.